Hello children, welcome to the next session of tables and shares. So let's start our session with the statement question. So here in the picture you can see there is some children are there and a grandfather. So Rashi, Seema, Mridul, Rohit and Lokesh asked their grandfather to give them some money for the fair. So all children want to go to the fair and they require money. So now with this statement we understand that grandfather will give some money and we have to distribute that money among all the children into equal parts. So grandfather says that I have 70 rupees in my pocket. Tell me how to share money equally among all of you. If you are right, you will get this money. So now one method that Rashi and Seema does that by dividing. So the total amount of rupees was 70. So, and how many children are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So, we have to divide the number 70 by 5. So, here the number 70 will be our dividend and number 5 will be our divisor. So, let's see how the Seema and Rashi does the all calculation. If you'll come below, you can see how she has divided the number 70. So for that we should know the table of 5. So we know that we can do it directly also or indirectly also. So 5 tens of 50, so the remaining is 20 rupees. So it means grandfather gave first 10 rupees to each children. So when he gave 10 rupees to each children, it means now 50 rupees he has spent and 20 rupees are left, and there are how many children are 5. So now this for 20 rupees have to be distributed among the children in equal amount. So further Rashi completes the division by again 5 fours are 20. So now 20 minus 20 remainder is 0. So it means that grandfather first gave 10 rupees to each, then he gave 4 rupees each. So total he has given 40 rupees to each children. Moving on, another method. Mridul and Lokesh are trying to divide 70 divided by 5 in a different way. So how, let's see how the boys are doing this thing. So Lokesh writes dividend divisor like this. But now he is dividing the number 70 in a unique way. So 5 5s are 25. So 70 minus 25 answer is 45. So here now it means that in the first when the grandfather distributed the amount of rupees in the first row, it means he have given 5 rupees to each children. 5 rupees to 5 children. Total 25 rupees he has spent. So how much remained with grandfather? 45. So now again grandfather has to give some amount of money to the all the children. So 5 6 are 30 because we cannot completely divide this. So again these boys are doing in this way. So now 45 minus 30, the answer will be 50. So it means after giving first the grandfather give 5 rupees to each, then 6 rupees to each. So after that 15 rupees are left. So now after the 15 rupees are left with grandfather, now grandfather has to distribute the 15 rupees equally to all the 5 children. So how it can be done? So what he can do, he can give further plus 3. 5 3 is a 15. So 15 minus 15 0. So it means first of all grandfather gave 5 rupees to each children, then 6 rupees to each children, and then 3 rupees to each children. So total how many rupees he has given? 5 plus 6 plus 3 is 14. So the answer is same, but the method the girls and boys did was different. So now similar kind of a situation is given below. Let's do that question. So here we can see that Now use your own method to divide rupees 70 equally among 5 people. So we can distribute rupees 70. So here two situations have been given, that if you want, you can start by giving 2 rupees to each, and you can even start by giving rupees 11 to each. So let's try to do this in a different way. I'll divide the children in columns. Children number 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 5. So if I give all the children 2 rupees each, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. So how many rupees I have spent? I have spent 10 rupees. So again, I will give 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. Again, I have given 10 rupees. So in this way, when I will give 2 rupees to each children, and this process will take time, because we will have to give the 2 rupees to each children. How many times? 7 times. So that the total amount can be distributed among the 5 children. So let's see how it can be done. 2, 2, 2. Grandfather gave for third time. Then 2, 2, 2, 2. Fifth time. Sixth time. So we can see that grandfather had distributed 2 rupees each to all the children. How many times? 7 times. So we can check our answer by 7 into 10. Answer is 70. It means all the total 70 rupees has been distributed equally. Come back to the textbook. So in this way, you can use your own method, or you can use your own creative way to distribute the rupees 70 in any kind of different way. So here one situation is also given in this question, that the aunt is saying that can you start rupees 15 to each. So is it possible to give rupees 15 to each? Suppose there are how many children? 5. And we have to give rupees 15 to each. So 15 5 is how much? 75. So it is not possible, because grandfather is having total 70 rupees. But the amount, if he have to give 70 rupees each, then it will be what? 75. So it is not possible. So this question is for your homework. Now moving on, we'll solve some questions based on this method only. So here, Meera made 204 candles to sell in the market. She makes the packets of 6. How many packets she will make? So it means Meera made how many candles total? 206. And she makes a packet of 6. So it means in one packet, how many candles are there? 6. So how many total packets she will be making? So we will make the number dividend 204, and we will divide it with 6. So let's see, 2 comes in the table of 6, no. So we'll take 0 also. 20 comes in the table of 6, no. But 18 comes in the table of 6, which is less than 20. So 6 3 is 18, minus 2 is remainder. We'll bring 4 down. So let's see that 24 comes in the table of 6, yes. 6 4 is 20. Remainder is 0. It means that Meera will make total 34 packets. So this is the answer when she is packing how much candles? She is packing 6 candles in one packet. So let's see what happens if she's packing 12 candles in one packet. Now the divisor will change. If she packs them in packet of 12, then how many packets she has to make? So situation changes. Dividend will be the same. Now divisor will change. So let's see that 20 comes in the table of 2. No. 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24. So we'll bring 12 only. Now 20 minus 12 is 8. So let's see that 84 comes in the table of 12. Yes, 12 sevens are 84. So our remainder is 0. So now Meera will make total 17 packets. So moving on to the next question. So on the sports day, 161 children are in school playground. They are standing in 7 equal rows. How many children are there in each row? So we have to find out that in one row how many children are there. So we have the total number of children and we have the number of rows. So we have the dividend 161 and divisor is 7. So again 7 1 is 7, 7 2 is 14, 7 3 is 21. So it will go 7 2 is 14. Now we'll bring 1 here. So let's see, 21s come in the table of 7. Yes, 7 3 is 21. So now how many children are standing in one row? In each row 23 children are standing. So this is how you have to solve this question. These questions will be provided in your homework also. Now move to the textbook. This will be the last session of this chapter. Now story problems. Now earlier what we were doing, we were solving the questions and we were finding the solution. So let's see the story problem. Srishti's grandma is asking her to make problems. So situation will be given to you and you have to find out the question, that how the questions will be framed. So as you can see here, crates of bottles are there. Total how many crates? 3. And in each crate 24 bottles are there. So what kind of a question can be asked with the help of this situation, that how many bottles are in all? How many bottles are there in all? So we can know that how many bottles are there in all. So how we'll do this kind of a question, that there are how many crates? 3. In each crate how many bottle? 1 crate, 24. Multiply with 24, we'll get the answer. The 3 4s are 12 and 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7. 72 total bottle. So with this, move to the next one. Now we have to find out the questions. First of all, we have to frame the question, then we have to find out the answer also. So here, Rakhi packets, in each packet how many Rakhis are there? 6. So what kind of a question may come? We can write, how many Rakhis are there? So 8 into 6, 48 Rakhis are there. Similarly, sugar packets are there. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 packets of sugar. And Saurabh paid 110 rupees for all the packets. So question can be framed how? That we know that there are 10 packets and we know the total value of all the packets. So what we should find? We should find the value of one packet. So what is the price of one packet? So these kind of question can be framed. Okay, moving on. Now here you can see there are 35 students in 7 row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And total students are how many? 35. Each row has same number of students. So what should be found? That in one row how many students are there? If we can look at the picture, we can find it easily, but we have to frame a question. So How many students are there in each room? So this is how we'll frame the question for this situation. Moving on. So Hari, Seema, Chinku and Lakshmi are going to Guwahati. Cost of one rail ticket is 62 rupees. How many are there? You can see Hari, Seema, Chinku and Lakshmi. All are 4. And the cost of one rail ticket is 62. So what kind of a question you can think with using this situation? That I can think that how much they will pay for all tickets. Okay, it means how many travelers are there? 4, and the price of one ticket is rupees 62. So if we'll multiply 4 into 62, we'll get the total amount that they have to pay for the 4 tickets. So 4 2 is 8 and 4 6 is 24. So they will pay 248 rupees. Last question for the session, and with this question we will end the chapter. So 1 meter of cloth cost rupees 20. Lal Bhaiya bought some cloth and paid rupees 140. So the cost of 1 meter cloth is rupees 20, but Lal Bhaiya bought some cloth and paid rupees 40. So total amount Lal Bhaiya has paid rupees for 140 and 1 meter itna. So question can be framed: how much meter of cloth Lal Bhaiya bought? Because we know the value of 1 meter and we know the total amount he has given. So how we can do this thing? That 140 will be the dividend and 20 will be the divisor. So can we do with this? Yes, because we know the table, that's 2 sevens of 14. So if we'll multiply with 7, it will be the same. It means answer is 7 meter. So that's all, children, from my side. With this we'll end the session about tables and share. Enjoy your holidays. Thank you.